Yes. When did your meeting point happen, actually?
That was in college.
Okay. No. You should not think that he was singing for my dance and we fell in love. No, it's not like that.
Both of you were in Bangalore at that time.
Yeah, we studied in MES College and we were classmates.
Okay. coming to your joint collaborations, which is again a very important aspect of your life, where you've been singing for many of our dance performances also. Yeah. So, I mean, this is a very complex thing because many full-time performers do not sing for dance. Still, the taboo is there. So, do you think really that makes any difference in dance?
Unfortunately for him, I'm his wife.
Okay.
Unfortunately for his husband.
As a professional, do you find any hitches in doing dual roles? That's what I want to
I think now the when we started our journey together as husband wife, there was a taboo. So a lot of very senior vidwans who used to accompany me used to mention, why are you singing for dance for your wife also? That time I told I sing only for her anyway, but I love to sing for her. I mean, not that sing, but it is to be enjoyment. I used to derive from it was a different sort of approach, singing for dance. And I do not think it's any way going to reduce your musicianship by singing for dance.
Having your own husband singing for you, what is the kind of advantage you have in terms of thought process? I'm asking.
First of all, I dance for his tune.
On the stage only.
In terms of the thought process of what to anticipate from a singer as a singer, do you have anything?
I know him like, 34, 35 years now. So I know his music so much that I know exactly what he can deliver, and even when he thinks, he knows exactly what I can do. So sometimes the music follows my dance, sometimes my dance follows his music. So it's a beautiful journey together.